Welcome to another Tuesday. In this one, it's all about the most important tool of all, the computer. And since mine is already a couple of years old, I decided to upgrade it to get optimal performance. So I'm gonna now install a 500GB SSD card to run both Windows and my music projects. And then I'm going to install 16GB of memory in comparison to the 8GB which I installed right now. But before we can start rebuilding the computer, we have to do a couple of stuff in Windows itself. So let's do that. Okay, the most important thing before doing any changes to your system is to back up your data. I'm using the free FileSync software to copy all my partitions over to my external NAS. In addition, I'm synchronizing a couple of folders with my Synology NAS DirectSync software. I've already done this, so no need to do it now. Because we are reinstalling Windows, I have to deactivate all my licenses. Let's go to iLog. iLog is used by a lot of different manufacturers in order to license the plugins. Here it's very important to select them all and to deactivate them. Because if you don't do that, all your licenses will be lost forever if you reinstall Windows. So just confirm it. And now we see on a work PC that there are zero activations. I'm now in Cubase because a couple of synthesizers can only be deactivated within their plugin interface. Let's go to Spire and go to Menu on Register. The other one is Silence, which similarly has to be deactivated within the menu of the plugin. That being done, the next thing is to create the installation media to actually be able to reinstall Windows on the SSD. To create the installation media for Windows, download the media creation tool from the Microsoft website. It first takes a little while to load, and then we can accept the license agreement and just follow the setup. The only important thing we have to set up is that we create an installation media and that we do not upgrade this PC, because we want to install the current operating system onto a different hard disk. So let's do that. The settings are taken from the actual machine right now, and then I take the USB flash drive. You could as well burn a DVD. Here you can select your USB drive. I've already done this before, so I won't do it right now, but then it said USB stick. You select it, go to next, and install it. Now where all data is backed up, the licenses are deactivated and the installation media is created, we can start working on the computer. I take the opportunity to actually clean it up because there's quite some dust in it, which can be a very bad thing for cooling. So I'm gonna use my vacuum and just carefully take out all the dust. Okay, that being done, let's start by replacing the memory. Let's get the camera a bit closer. Okay, so let's start replacing the memory. The memory are the two sticks right here. To remove them, there are these little handles which you have to push down on both sides. Then you can just gently pull them out. So these are the old 8GB memory sticks. I'm now going to replace them with the Patriot Viper. These are two 8GB sticks, so 16 in general. To install them, you have to pay attention. There's a smaller part and a larger part, and this lines up with the plastic piece on the board itself. So you gently insert them, and then you can push at the bottom and at the top. And you notice this click. If it doesn't click, it is not installed correctly. So the second stick. Okay, cool. So that's done. So let's get to the SSD. Here you see my old hard disk setup. So the computer is actually designed to have two HDD disks in it. But since I have too much data, I just put this one on top. Which is not the most elegant way to do it, but hey, it worked for a couple of years. I'm now gonna replace the oldest disk with the SSD. So we're gonna have two HDD and one SSD. So let me remove the disk here on top. Let's check how they are fixed. They are screwed in from the bottom, so I have to undo the two screws here. And by the way, some cases may be designed differently, so it always depends on your manufacturer. but I just want to give you a quick overview on how this stuff is done. And since I have now one proper slot, I'm gonna put the other 4 terabyte disk in this place. I just have to insert it the right way that these holes line up with these screws. So let's unpack the SSD. Remove this paper piece. Yeah, where the SSD goes, there are actually these plastic pieces you see right here. So let's take them out. And to be honest, I have actually no idea why they put these pieces here. So let's just take them out and screw them. So I'll show you, can just, there are these kind of rails where the disc fit into. So just put it in, so it can hold in place there somehow. I don't have the screws to fix them. I just have the 2 screws which were in the other hard disk. So I'm just gonna screw every hard disk with just 1 screw. This will probably be enough. Okay, perfect. So now they are all installed quite okay. And then I can just use the cables which ran to the old hard disk to the new SSD. So every hard disk is getting 1 power cable and 1 zeta cable. The zeta cable is actually doing the data and, well, the power cable, the electricity. Okay, so it can be a little bit finicky to get all the cables right, but I think I've got it. So I'm gonna connect the power, the monitor, and turn it on and see what happens. Okay, I got my power and monitor set up. So let's check if it starts. It's at least happening something. I'm gonna restart my monitor so it rescans all the inputs. Yes, so it tells me I have to reboot and to select a proper boot device or insert a boot media. And this makes totally sense because I removed the hard disk where Windows is installed. I have to reinstall now with the installation media which we created earlier. Okay, so I now installed the USB stick with the installation media on it. So after putting the installation media in and starting the computer, we have to set a couple of settings. Your settings may vary depending on what type of format you prefer and what keyboard you are using. Then you just simply go to install now. So the setup takes a moment to start. So you're gonna read all the license and accept it. Because we're doing a clean install, we have to go on custom. So now I have to choose where I'm going to install Windows. So I'm seeing a couple of partitions. The ones which already have a name are obviously the ones which I used in the past. And then down here we have a 465 GB unallocated space, which is the 500 GB SSD. I'm just gonna select this one and go to next. It just takes a while to install it. So see you in a while. So the install is now finished. And now you have to set in a couple of settings. But it's here very important to actually take the right settings, because there are a couple of things which can't be changed later on unless you reinstall Windows. Because at this point screen capture is not possible, I'm just gonna read you through it. Let's start with region. Is this correct? Germany. Yes. Is the keyboard layout correct? Okay, this was wrong, so I select Swiss French and go to yes. Do you want to add a second keyboard layout? Not now. And then it asks you to connect to the internet, because the new Windows versions wants you to log in with a live account. But I don't want that. I just want to be offline as much as possible. So I click I don't have internet. And then it really wants you to get into the internet. You continue with limited setup, because that's the only way to create an offline account. At a later point, you can always connect internet and it will work just fine. Okay, so now I just have to put in my username, my password, and confirm the password. Okay, so it wants you to put some security questions. I'm not too much a fan of that, but let's do that. And now it's getting interesting. It asks you to do speech recognition and stuff. And you generally, for maximum privacy, always want to select the one which Windows doesn't select for you. You don't want to give Microsoft your location. You don't want to give the location again. You don't want to send data to them. You don't want to get their typing sent there. You don't want to get a tailored diagnostic stuff because they're sending again data. And you don't want to have advertising. And then hear the Cortana thing. Not now, I don't want to have Cortana on my system. So I'm gonna as well not enable this. Now it's just cutting runs through and installing some stuff in the background. So it all worked out right now. I've now put back the computer on its place right here, hooked up all the monitors, and I'm now ready at the personalization phase. So I just went here to the personalize stuff and then going through all the different tabs to put the colors and the lock screen, everything how I prefer it. And now the ordeal begins to install all plugins. I mean, it will take a while, all the DAWs, all the plugins, but that's what we have to go through. For now, this is all I want to show you about my computer upgrade. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them below. And if you learn something, consider liking and subscribing. And see you in the next one.